Oil and gas producers use gas back pressure regulators to provide control of oil and gas production processes. In this video, we'll cover the 10 most common applications for this regulator. Our original back pressure regulator is the industry standard for holding back pressure of 300 PSI or less. However, if you need to hold back pressure above 300 PSI, you can use our high pressure control valve in these applications as well. Natural gas, being lighter than water and oil, rises to the top of the vessel where it begins to separate from the well stream. The natural gas flows through the outlet at the top of the vessel and into a Kimray back pressure regulator. The back pressure regulator holds constant pressure on the vessel to allow it to move liquids to the next destination. Any gas pressure over the regulator's set point will be sent downstream to additional separation, gas treating, or sales. On a two-phase free water knockout, a spring-loaded back pressure regulator will be used on the oil emulsion outlet. This is distinct from the standard back pressure regulator, which can only be used to regulate the flow of gas, not liquid. On a three-phase vessel, a spring-loaded back pressure regulator or standard back pressure regulator will be used on the gas outlet. When the upstream pressure overcomes the spring tension in the regulator, the valve will open and send the oil emulsion downstream to be processed further. On a compressor, the back pressure regulator can be used as a low suction recycle valve. If there is a shortage of volume or pressure of the inlet gas, it can cause pressure to drop below the set point. When this happens, the low suction recycle valve will open and pressure will travel from the compressor discharge back to the inlet side. The compressor will continue to operate with this low suction recycle valve open until suction pressure returns. This low suction recirculation valve will prevent the compressor from shutting down due to low suction pressure. If the compressor discharge pressure rises above the set point of the high discharge recirculating valve, it will open and send pressure to the upstream side of the suction control valve. This high discharge recycle valve will prevent the compressor from shutting down on high discharge pressure. The back pressure to vacuum regulator can operate with a vacuum on the downstream side of this regulator. This vacuum is most commonly created by a VRU, which gathers gas from low pressure vent lines of control devices. Producers use VRUs to lower gas emissions and increase efficiency. On a dehydration unit, the back pressure regulator can be used to hold back pressure on the flash separator. On a flash separator, the back pressure regulator is located on the gas outlet piping, meaning it will control the pressure inside the vessel. Inside the flash separator, the separated gas travels along the top of the skimmer and passes through a mist extractor before exiting through the back pressure valve. The back pressure to flare regulator is installed in case there is maintenance on the sales line or there is an overpressure of equipment. If the pressure set point of this regulator is met, it opens, sending the gas to a combustor or flare to be incinerated until the conditions change. In a heater treater, after separation of the oil emulsion occurs, the gas rises to the top of the vessel where it travels through a back pressure regulator. From this regulator, the gas can travel to either a sales line or flare. On a LACT unit, oil moves through a back pressure regulator, which holds pressure against the LACT unit. This is typically a spring-loaded back pressure regulator because it requires no supply gas to operate. Where you're having issues regulating consistent pressure with wet gas, you can replace the standard back pressure regulator with our back pressure regulator with outside supply in any of these applications, except the VRU. You may also hear it called the liquid back pressure regulator. Using an outside source of supplied air or clean gas, this regulator can operate in wet gas conditions with no negative effects on the valve. The supply is completely isolated from the upstream and downstream sides of the regulator. If you have any questions about any of these regulators or applications they're used in, please leave a comment below.